EA Sports. It's in the game.
We're live and getting ready for what should be another great NFL matchup. Thanks for joining us again for today's coverage. I think we're in for a good one today as the AFC North champion Steelers square off against the Seahawks. Much anticipated game ready to begin as we're lined up for the kickoff. Brown looks like he's just about ready to kick this one off. Should be a return here from the 11. The 30. Let's see how effective they can be with their first drive of the game. Our EA Sports Coach Close-Up features two of the more meticulous coaches in the NFL. Bill Cowher has been with the Steelers organization since 1992 and has built up an impressive resume, including 9 postseason appearances and 5 appearances in the AFC Championship game. Dropping back. Closing in. Gets rid of it. And this pass is completed. Bullwear stops him. Johnny had a big speed advantage.
Yeah, he's one of those guys who's a good straight line runner, so you can't let him get behind you. If you do, then there aren't going to be too many guys who are going to be able to run and catch him.
Second member of our EA Sports Coach Close-Up is Mike Holmgren, who's now in his 7th season as head coach of the Seahawks. Last year, they won the NFC West with a record of 9-7. Wistrom with the tackle at the 43. Gets the call on the misdirection play and picks up about 4 yards. The Steelers come into this game very confident that their offense can take over and create all kinds of problems for the defense, John.
This team's very good at freezing the defense. Doesn't sound like much, but getting the defense to hesitate for just a split second to make the difference between a short gain or a first down.
With the throw, and it's complete. And it's good for a first down. Ball on the 36-yard line. The Seahawks with a 4-man front. Gets the call. Bullwear brings him down at the 28. And the ball carrier was brought down by the safety. They need to get the ball inside the 26-yard line to convert for the first down. The Seahawks come out in a 4-3. They give it to the halfback. They're going to spot this one at the 19-yard line. The Steelers ran the ball successfully that time and have picked up another first down. That's 3 on the drive. 6th play of this drive. They're in field goal range. Bettis, the lone back. Roethlisberger with a man in motion. Hands off to the tailback. Pickup of about 6 yards.
Gain of 6 on the play.
The first down marker is just inside the 9. Ward lines up on the right side. To the end zone. Gets his hand on it. Wilson was his intended target. Hamlin was there on the cover. Eighth play of this drive. Ward is lined up on the right. Drops back with the pass. Jumping and has it.
Nice. Makes the stop. Good job picking up the blitz and picking up a first down.
Hey, that was a heck of a call. I mean, they saw the pressure was coming, and he knew right where to go with the ball. And then he got it there.
It's first and goal at the 3.
Ward is on the right of the formation. So a fly to the end zone. Knocked away. Wilson was the intended receiver on that play.
It's second and goal at the 3-yard line.
Ward is lined up on the right. Looking for the goal line. Setting up play action to the end zone. Broken up. Trying to get it in for 6. But put third down.
It's third and goal at the 3.
Fisher is there on the stop at the 4-yard line.
No gain.
Trying to get it in on the ground, and the defense says, not this time.
We've reached the end of the first quarter, and we're all tied up.
Teams have switched sides, and we'll start the second quarter. The kick is up. The kick is good. A number of plays run on that drive, and it was enough to get them close enough for a field goal.
Each play you run on offense tires out the defense a little more. When you can put together that many plays in a row, it gets you into scoring position. This time, it got them free.
Reed aims to kick this one off. Nice kick and returnable. From the 11-yard line. So the offense sets up for its first drive of the game. Ball on their own 30. Jackson is lined up on the right. Dropping back to pass on first down. Fumbled. The Steelers scoop up the fumble. The defense comes up with a fumble and a touchdown. He recovers the loose ball and finds his way to the end zone. They'll line up for the extra point. And it's up. The extra point attempt is good. Will be kicking off. The kick should be returnable. From the 16. The 30. The last time the defense was on the field, they scored on a fumble return. Ball on their own 37. Jackson lines up on the right side. Pressure coming. Throwing.
Incomplete pass.
Tatum was the one they were trying to get the ball to.
Polamalu
had the coverage on the play.
Alexander, the lone back. Hasselback with a man in motion. Dropped in the backfield for a short loss. They went back on that one.
And that's a very good call by the defensive coordinator. He had a good idea of what was coming, and he called the perfect play to stop it.
So it's third down and long. They'll go from the I formation. Throws it. He's pushed out at the 36. Just a beautiful play call that went a long way.
Keith can say that again. I really like to watch these guys play. Big gainers like that can happen just about any time they drop back to pass.
2 minute warning coming up. Only one man back. He hands it off. Polamalu comes up to make the play. Alexander kept his legs moving, gets 7 hard-earned yards. And this is the 5th play of this drive, so they need about 3 here. Gets the pass off. He hits his receiver. Foot is there for the tackle. The offense is going to hurry things up here. Dropping back the pass on first down. With the pass, and it's complete. Touchdown, Seahawks.
This is a good play by the offense in the red zone. The wide receiver is going to break away right here and come up with a catch and the touchdown.
It's on its way. The extra point attempt is good. The Seahawks are just 3 points down now. Get a reminder, John, this team can get hot at any time.
That defense is going to have to figure out a way to stop them the next time so they don't pick up too much momentum.
The Seahawks are ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing. This one is handled by Taylor. Pittsburgh takes over on offense, looking to extend their lead. So they have 1st and 10 here. They'll go from the I formation. They're trying to jump the snap count. So he's called for encroachment.
Yeah, he jumped early and touched an offensive player, and that forces the officials to blow the whistle.
Following the penalty, it's now 1st and 5. Ward lines up on the right side. Rid of it. Incomplete as the defender nuts it away. A little lob doesn't find its intended target.
The defense can't afford to take too many gambles by going for a pick when they should just try and knock it down. One mistake can lead to a big play for the offense.
Roethlisberger starts out of the shotgun. Dropping back with the throw, almost intercepted. Trufant was there on the coverage. Defense! Defense! Third down coming up.
I'm looking for that back to sneak out into the flat. It's been there a few times before, and they might try it again right here.
Ward is on the right of the formation. Throwing. He finds his man. The 30, the 20, the 10, and he high steps his way to the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh.
I'll tell you, this is nice work by both the quarterback and the receiver in this play. Watch it here. He reads the coverage, looks for the best option, and then throws it to him.
The kick is up. The point after is good. They have a double-digit lead now following that end zone trip. Well, you can't ask for much more out of a drive that gets you into the end zone.
They did everything they had to on that one. The end result is a trip across the goal line and a TD on the board.
Looks like he's just about ready to kick this one off. They'll return this one. From the 11-yard line. Slips the tackle. The 30. Couldn't stop them from getting into the end zone the last time out. We're guessing they're going to just throw it and do their best to move into scoring range since they don't want to go into the half with the score the way it is. Ball on their own 41. Jackson lines up on the right side. Down he goes. And the pressure got to the quarterback.
You know what they're doing is running a 3-4. The offensive linemen aren't sure who's coming and who's dropping back. And that's delayed to a man coming free to the quarterback.
Ooh, nearly picked off. Didn't look off the defender, and he's lucky that one wasn't picked.
The intended receiver on the play.
Hey, if the coach has confidence in his quarterback, they'll probably throw for it. But he looks at the big picture and sees what could go wrong. He may just run it and send out his punt team.
Tucks it away. Hope brings him down. Not getting the first down, that will probably bring out the punter. Now here's the punt unit as the defense forces a three and out. Here's the punt. He signals for a fair catch.
Fair catch made at the 16-yard line.
With halftime quickly approaching, they'll probably just run out the clock and go to the locker room with the lead. Ball on their own 16. Ward lines up on the right side. With the pass, and he can't hang on. So they don't get the completion, and the defense got a little lucky there.
They'd need a big play here if they want to have any shot at scoring before the half.
The Seahawks come out in a 4-3. Stiff arms the defender to the ground. Number 58 makes the play. So let's take a look at how this back compares to the opposition.
2 yards to go. It's the end of the second quarter with the score, Pittsburgh 17, Seattle 7. As we take a look at his success returning kicks, we get ready for the kickoff. Here we go, the second half, just about set for the kickoff. Not a bad kick, they'll set up for the return. This one is taken by Payton. The Seahawks could not establish the running game in the first half. Ball on their own 28. Straw lines up on the left side. Throws it. This one falls incomplete. Too much on that throw, sailing over the receiver's head. The Steelers come out in a nickel package. With the pass. Incomplete as the defender knocks it away. He was in the right place at the right time, and that saved them from giving up a lot of yardage. Hasselback with split backs. Throwing. He hits his receiver. A great one-on-one stop by Paul Mallow. Perfect play. And they gain 36 on third down. It's first and 10. Jackson comes in motion. Porter makes the stop. The linebacker brought him down to the turf. They need to reach the 25 to convert. Alexander lines up behind his fullback in the eye. Hand it off. Hope stops him at the 17.
This is a great block. Watch here. He just barrels into the defender, taking him right off the turf. Now that is a textbook block right there.
Rid of it. Incomplete. Mealy was the intended receiver on that play. And this is the seventh play of this drive. Jackson is on the right of the formation. Drops back. Under pressure. Throwing. And he steps out of bounds. At the 15.
Look here, he does two things perfectly on this play. One, he watches the ball all the way into his hands to make the catch. And two, he shows great awareness and gets both feet down in bounds. Hey, that's a nice looking play.
Here are the numbers when it comes to third down conversions. Pressure, gets rid of it, and he hits his target. Holclaw brings him down at the 6.
This is good communication between the quarterback and his receiver to keep the chains moving. They know where the first down marker is, and they recognize the type of coverage the defense is playing. The ball is there, and so is the catch.
Strong, the motion man. Crosses it out to the right. Higgins is there for the tackle. Now let's have a look at what our runners have done up to this point. It's second and goal at the five. They'll go from the I formation. Hands it off. Setting up play action through the end zone. Touchdown, Seattle.
This is exactly how you execute the play pass. The quarterback does a great job of selling the run, and that freezes the defense long enough for his receiver to get open in the end zone for the score.
It's up. The point after is good. The Seahawks can tie it up with a field goal. A good looking drive, and they score the touchdown. And the offensive unit should be very pleased with their performance on that one.
Yeah, they were able to get some other players involved. Anytime you can accomplish that, it gets your whole team excited.
Brown is back and ready to put this one in the air. It's on its way. From the 9. The 20. Pittsburgh is up by a field goal. Is lined up on the right. Roethlisberger with a man in motion. Pass play here on first down. Gets rid of it. Almost picked off. Dice had the coverage on the play. The Seahawks come out in a 4-3. Hand it off to the back. Number 58 comes up to make the play. And now our viewers can see how successful each team's main running threat has been today. Here is a third and long situation. Ward lines up on the right side. And that'll be the last play of the third quarter. We're separated by only a field goal. With the score, Pittsburgh 17, Seattle 14. And we'll start the fourth quarter. And we're at the 3-minute mark. They give it to the halfback. Herndon is there for the tackle. Well, that didn't cut it. Now they're looking at fourth down.
And they made the decision to just keep it on the ground. Take time off the clock, not force anything. This is a luxury of being ahead.
Nothing happening on that drive, and they'll punt it away. The kick. won't take a chance trying to return this one. Two-minute warning coming up. Jackson is lined up on the right. Throwing. He hits his receiver. Barry takes him down. Mealy makes the catch, but for a short gain, maybe 3 yards. Almost at the two-minute mark now. Right. 2 minutes left. Alexander is on the right of the formation. Back, closing in, gets rid of it. This one falls incomplete, and they have to go to the air because they need big plays fast.
That's right, you gotta have composure in these situations. Find your receivers who can pick up yardage after the catch. But most importantly, you have to keep the chains moving.
Only one man in the backfield. With the throw, finds his man, Townsend, with the stop. So after that nice catch and run, here's a look at his stats. Pass play here on first down. Gets the pass on. It's batted away. No choice here, John. They just have to keep throwing.
Yeah, they do. Running the ball isn't going to do a whole lot of good now.
Fifth play of this drive. Hasselback with a man in motion. Dropping back. Goes with a short pass to the right side. He shakes the defender. He's brought in three so far. Looking to convert on third down, they have to get it to the 42. The Steelers come out in a nickel package. Pressure coming, throws it, and caught. Great effort there. Let's see how this defense handles a no-huddle. Dropping back to pass on first down. Gets rid of it, drops the interception. Time is working against them.
Yeah, I'm thinking they're going to keep going to the air, but it might be a little too late.
And this is the eighth play of this drive. With the pass, and he makes the grab. Jackson with a decent 6-yard gain. So as they get set to try to convert, here's what both teams have done on third down. Under pressure, throws it. Oh, records the stop. He's trying to hurry them back to the line. Going to the air on first down. They can take the lead here. Touchdown, Seahawks.
Touchdown, Seattle.
Excellent composure in the pocket. He gives them the lead here in the fourth. Brown comes in for the extra point. It's on its way. The point after is good. The Seahawks leading in the game, but not by much. Well, this game clearly isn't over yet, John. That touchdown puts them ahead, but only by a slim margin. And there's plenty of time left.
Yeah, but they're going to have to hurry. They need to make sure that they keep their eye on that clock and use every second of it to their advantage.
The Seahawks are lined up for the kickoff. Squib kick here. This one is handled by Taylor. The 20. The Steelers can't afford to waste much time as they take over.
Time is a factor, but I think they can still use the middle of the field.
First and 10. Ward lines up on the right side. Gets rid of it. Incomplete as the defender knocks it away. No pass reception on that play, John, and that's surprising considering his reputation.
He's always been able to catch a ball. He has soft hands and good body control. He ran a good route, and the quarterback made the right read. He just didn't bring it in.
Out of the gun. Gets the pass off. The pass ball's incomplete. Trufant with the coverage. Third and long, but needing a touchdown, they'll be going for it on fourth down as well if they can't pick up the first here. Roethlisberger scans the defense from the gun. With the pass, and he makes the grab. Dyson is there on the stop. And a flag is down on that play. His face mask may have been pulled.
On the defense, number 22.
They called it inadvertent.
You know, there's so many limbs flying and body parts moving around. You just tackle whatever you can and you grab anything that's moving. Sometimes you get a handful of mass.
Ball on their own 44. Ward lines up on the right side. Steps up, throwing. Jumps up and comes down with a good gain of 28 on first down. And this is the fifth play of this drive. And they find themselves in scoring range. Out of the shotgun. Throws it. Goes up, makes it down. A gain of 24 yards that time. And it's first and goal. It's first and goal at the 3-yard line. Miller, the motion man. On the delay. Sharper makes the tackle. Big collision on that play.
Yeah, the goal line is one place where you're guaranteed to get a little whap and a little boom.
They're just 3 yards away from the end zone. Ward is on the right of the formation. Roethlisberger with a man in motion. Pressure. Lobs one into the end zone. Close to a touchdown, but he couldn't get his feet in.
This is one of the most practiced situations in football. Trying to catch a pass in the end zone because it's one of the hardest things to do.
And as the official takes a look at the play, so will we.
And the issue here is that the official called him out of bounds. Now you have to look. And not only did he get both feet in bounds, but did he have possession?
The call on the field is overturned.
It was unclear initially why they called for a review, but now we understand the reason.
Yeah, it's important to get the calls right at this point of the game.
Here's the winner of the Horse Trailer Award. Reed comes in to attempt the point after. The kick is up. The extra point attempt is good. The Steelers find themselves up by a small margin. What a turn of events as they move ahead by a field goal here in the fourth quarter and a game that figures to go right down to the wire.
These are the kind of games you love. The crowd's into it. The coach's brains are in overdrive. The players are all hyped up. Everything that could be switched on is switched on.
The kickoff team lines up. Squib kick. This one is taken by Payton. They head back out onto the field after scoring a touchdown on their last possession. And the passing game worked to perfection. So we'd expect them to try to continue to do the same thing and move the ball through the air against this defense. First and 10. Jackson lines up on the right side. With the throw, and he makes the grab. And it'll be second and less than two following that pass for decent yardage.
I'll tell you, when you've got second and short, you can call just about anything and everything. Because if you don't get it on this play, you can always go back out there on third, and you'll still only need a yard or two for the first down.
Here we go. One last chance, and they have to come up with some kind of a miracle play to pull this one out. Hulk is the guy who's there to bring him down at the 33. So this could be the last play of the game. And it all comes down to this. They have to get it into the end zone or it's over. Throwing. Incomplete pass. We've come to the end of this one. And the score is 24-21. For EA Sports, this is Al Michaels and John Madden wishing you a very pleasant good evening.